nursing facility there, and I'm working there with many of the incumbent and retired Jesuits. I completed a nursing program many years ago at Boston College, so I give you information and take your book for the same time. Let us begin today's liturgy.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
First of all, Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
With your spirit.
Pace a coloro che erano vicini. per mezzo di lui infatti possiamo presentarci gli uni e gli altri al Padre in un solo spirito. Parola di Dio.
Rendiamo grazie a Dio. Spirit.
Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Mark. The apostles gathered together with Jesus and reported all they had done and taught. Jesus said to them, "Come away by yourselves to a deserted place and rest a while." People were coming and going in great numbers, and they had no opportunity even to eat. So they went off in a boat by themselves to a deserted place. People saw them leaving, and many came to know about it. They hastened there on foot from all the towns and arrived at the place before them. When Jesus disembarked and saw the vast crowd, his heart was moved with pity for them. They were like sheep without a shepherd. And he began to teach them many things. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise the Lord Jesus Christ.
Fratello e sorello Cristo. Good morning, everybody.
Good morning.
Think of this Italian word, something that Nona might say. Guardami. Look at me. Guardami. Look at me. If you remember nothing else, guardami. Look at me. We have this message throughout our readings this morning. From the Old Testament, we hear about the need for a people to find their God, that they're lost like sheep in the wilderness, without a master, without some direction. The responsorial psalm we hear, "The Lord is my shepherd. I don't need anything else," right? "There's nothing I shall need. He guides me, he teaches me, he directs me. He's my source of hope and life." In the New Testament reading, the second reading, we hear the same message, and now Christ has come, and not only has he come to live and dwell among us, but he has died for us, so that we never have to worry about being lost again. The sheep are never scattered anymore. They are still here, and he remains with us. Then we hear in the gospel the human side of Jesus. He sees a lot of people gathering. It's hot outside. Kids are running around. Some older people are struggling to get there. He wants to feed them. He wants to take care of them. Sounds to me like something Nona would want to do. To guide people. But again, look at his image. He says, "Look at me." He doesn't say, "Look at me," to show his elevated superiority. He says, "Look at me in terms of what I live my life on earth to show you how to follow me." I teach philosophy at Fordham University. And a lot of times when I'm speaking to our students about living ethically, I teach an ethics course, I say, keep these three H's in mind, because we walk around all day long with this reminder. Ready for your philosophy lesson? We have a head, we have a heart, and we have hands. H-H-H. Remember the triple H. It's not a wrestler, okay? H-H-H. We have a head, we have a heart, and we have our hands. So what is Jesus teaching us in the readings today? He says, "Look at me." When I was living among you on earth, I taught you how to be my shepherd, my sheep. Right? He was the good shepherd. So think about all the things you do in a day's past where you engage your head, your heart, and your hands. I'll give you a few concrete examples. And I think this is what he's teaching us. To look at him, look at his model on the cross and what he did for us, so we do for one another. Through your head. What does your head do? It has your mind, your brain. You pray from your head. You use words, but you also have thoughts and ideas. You have hopes for your kids. You have patience for your parents and grandparents. We have aspirations, right? We have our mind that we give to one another, and in turn, we offer that to God. So to use your mind, I tell my students, make sure you bust the sweat every day using your mind. God didn't give it to us just to hang out. Use it. Move down to your body, your heart. Think of all the things you believe in. Family, faith, and food. Three things that we hold dear to ourselves. Convictions that we have, what we stand for and what we won't stand for. Right, that sense of your character. Again, think of Nona, that she gives of herself a lot of times out of sacrifice because she feels so connected to you, just as Jesus does as the Good Shepherd. He would rather do without in order to provide for you. And then lastly, your hands. You can have a lot of great ideas in your mind and thoughts, a lot of strong beliefs in your heart. But if you don't get out there and use your hands to improve the world, Jesus would say you're not following what the shepherd has taught you. The shepherd doesn't shepherd from afar or just with ideas. He gets out there, rolls up his sleeves, and does the work. Right? So think of all the ways in which you carry on. Look at me. Follow Jesus. See what he's doing. You don't necessarily need to pray for hours and hours on end alone, or to just simply donate money or energy, but put it all together. How am I engaging my sincere mind today, the deep recesses of my heart, and my hands? Have I helped someone who's struggling up the steps? Have I helped a young child learn how to tie their shoes? Look at all the things that Jesus did by his modeled human model action. He talked to people who were lonely, who other people cast aside and didn't respect. He went out of his way to hang out with the kids, to learn about them, to learn about what they care about, to gather that sense of energy. But he also hung out with the elders too, to make sure everybody felt connected and part of the family. To look at me. The readings constantly point to that today, this idea of a shepherd, that we as the sheep who were wandering without any direction, God sent his only son to live among us, to experience like you and I do. He understood what it meant to be hungry and to be tired and to be lost and to be frustrated, to lose some sleep, to struggle. He understood that because he lived that among with us. So that if we see that image, to look at me, follow me, it makes a lot more sense. There's a reason why God sent his son to live among us, because otherwise it would be very difficult for us to abstract and think of a God who is abstract and outside of my reach. But we understand what Jesus' world was like, what his ministry was. It's what you and I pray that we continue here on earth. Last thing I'll just mention is think about those three H's. So what are ways tonight when you pray, not only might you have a memorized prayer or pray for the souls of those you love, that's great, but in addition to that, maybe I offer you to think about how have I used my head, my heart, and my hands so that you practice what you preach, so that we do look at Jesus, we do follow him, and we do honor all the effort that was made. Just like Nona does behind the scenes. Right, when I was a little kid, I was always amazed at huge parties we'd have in the backyard. And then as I got older, I realized, wow, that took a lot of work. But as a little kid, I didn't realize that. I thought it all happened just out of the blue. But she was up early to make sure the food was ready, to greet people, to honor one another, to care about somebody, to talk to that person who maybe was a little shy or embarrassed. Think of all the things that Jesus did in his earthly ministry to have us recognize who he was. It doesn't need to be an awful mystery if we look around and pay attention to all the signs that he gives us through the head, heart, and hands. Amen.
On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven. He is at the right hand of God above all might. There will come the judge to the living and the dead. And so he the Holy Spirit for all the Catholic Church, the union of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of body, and life everlasting.
Amen. Amen.
Gathered in joy, we offer our prayers to God, who creates hearts to love us all. For the church and those who serve the church, and for all those people who preach and practice the gospel of Christ, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the Jewish people, the first to hear the word of God, for their continued growth and love of his name and faithfulness to the covenant, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all the outcasts, for the downtrodden of our community and nation, for our churches and families who offer them refuge, compassion, and hope, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We ask for the Lord's abundant blessings of all those in our married life before us. For this we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
We also pray for the families and friends remembered at this Mass today, for all the support of one another in times of need, as we rejoice with one another. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all those family members who have gone before us, marked with the sign of faith, for them we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God, our Creator, guardian of our homes and source of blessings, we delight in the happiness of your people. May you hear our prayers through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving his holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance of your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Silverio, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession, in your presence we rely for our prayer. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis our Pope, Timothy our Bishop, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family when your Son is before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. And to our departed brothers and sisters, especially as we remember Bobichiro Yodichi, John Yodichi, the Yodichi family, Carmino Frank, after the second. And remember also all members of our families and our friends, and all who have been pleasing to you at their passing from this life. Give kind of interest to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. For it is through him, and with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor are yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
This day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days. That by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will. You will live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. The
peace of the Lord be with you all.
And your spirit.
Thank you.
Lord, I will do the secret. I will say the word, and I shall be healed.
Find about Christ, bring us to life everlasting.
I
original member. So I'm going to say a few words.
Morning, everybody. How are you?
Yes, sir.
Welcome to Silverio Shrine. Well, let me tell you something. This is called Membership Day. That all our members come here and enjoy the day with us, music and everything, and the mass. But let me explain to you about Membership Day. In 2000, we started the membership. For a couple of years, there was no mass. So Carmine and Prayer, his son had passed away, came up and says, why don't we do a mass on Sunday at Membership Day? And it was a good idea. At that time, there was Anthony Fiola, president, and Sylvia Mazzella, she was the secretary. And they said, let's keep it going. So, for 24 years, we've been doing this. Some people come, some people don't come, some people don't know. But this is called Membership Day. Now, all the money that the Shrine collects, I say about 40% of the money we collect goes to scholarship and donations to hospitals and what. We support as much as we could. With your little benefits, we do it. So we have a journal, and every year the journal is written. I have it on my chair there, and that money goes to these scholarships and to these children. The 55% goes to keep the Shrine going. Now all these people that are up there that are right now cooking and cleaning and doing everything, they're all volunteers. Over here, we got Jerry Conte is the vice president, and Neil Calisi is the president. They're only president because they voted me in. I am president for life. So, remember that? So, now I'm going to give you a little story. I think a lot of you didn't hear, but maybe. One time, it was the Sacred Heart of Jesus that they had to bring up here. So, Archito Mazzella, who helped build this place, he said, Ralph, can you send us a truck to bring the Sacred Heart up? I says, okay. Friday night, I sent the truck to his place. He put the Sacred Heart in the truck. And he put a lot of plywood and bricks in this. When the truck came to my yard, the back was sitting on the ground. Oh my God, I said, this truck is overweight. All right, Saturday morning came, myself and two other boys that volunteered and worked up here, came up. So, on the way up, the same troopers stopped us. And they say, oh, you're overweight. I said, really? Okay. He says, pull over on the side. I pulled over. We're going to put the scale. No. Give me the $500 violation. That's the minimum. He says, no, we got to put you on a scale. You're more than that. I says, okay. I said, but before you write the summons out, write it to the guy in the back. I says, what guy in the back? He says. I says, I'm doing a favor. I says, he's in the back. Really? You can't keep people in the back of the truck. I says, well, there's no room in the front. So open the doors. So I opened the doors. And the Sacred Heart was looking at him. And he was an Irish cop. And then he said to me, what is that? I says, you're Irish and you know Jesus Christ? He goes, yeah! I says, well, I'm taking him up to Sanctuary of Shrine in Dover Plains. So now you write the ticket out to him. And when you get to heaven, if you do, try to collect it. And on my way, he let me go, and we came up and we delivered the sacred ark. So these are the things that was done up here. All the steel and everything that you see here, some of my trucks brought it, and most of my trucks brought it. So I have a very strong faith in the saints of every home. I stay here every night, and there's no problem. Sometimes I have company stay with me, and there's no problem. So I have a trailer that sleeps six people comfortably. If anybody wants to hang out some nights, come on up and jump in the pool. Enjoy the pool. But we need members, and we need help. I want to build where we grew up, Our Lady of Pity Museum. I'm trying to get it done. I have the artifacts from Our Lady of Pity sitting up on top of the hill. But someday, before the Lord calls for me, I'll see that building up. And I am looking forward to get an amphitheater in the baseball field. All right? Thank you, and enjoy the day.
Signore, we have once again Vittorio.
Hai scassato il telefono, io sapevo.
Degli occhi tuoi, ma non so il colore. Con me piccolo fiore, dove vai? Perché vai in giro per il mondo? Se ti fermassi solo un momento, ti accorgeresti che c'è qualcuno. Qualcuno che ti vuole amare e non ha paura dell'amore, come tu sai si può soffrire e qualche volta si può anche morire.
Mantieni sempre dritti questo.
Come io per te,
come io per te,
come io per te,
come io per te.
Degli occhi tuoi non so il colore, ma sono belli più grandi del mare. Non hanno pianto, ma è per amore. Come vorrei averti vicina, sentir la tua voce ancora di bambina, restare con te mentre fuori piove. Per vivere con te tutte le mie gioie. Piccolo fiore, dove vai? Perché vai in giro per il mondo? Se ti fermassi solo un momento, ti accorgeresti che c'è qualcuno, qualcuno che ti vuole amare e non ha paura dell'amore, come tu sai si può soffrire. Qualche volta si può anche morire, come io per te,
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 we have a lot of leftover, we have a lot of fruits, we have cakes, ice cream, I'm trying to bring to your house, not a problem. Okay, Vittorio, cosa ci fai ascoltare allora?
Pregherò.
Pregherò, don't go away. Vittorio ci farà ascoltare, pregherò.
Pregherò. Siamo andati a Cito.
Thank you.
se tu lo vorrai, crederai. Io lo so perché tu la fede non hai, ma se tu lo vorrai, crederai. Non devi odiare il sole perché tu non puoi vederlo, ma c'è, ora splende su di noi, su di noi. Dal castello gode il silenzio e chi vede anche te, e già sento che anche tu lo vedrai. E mi sa che lo vedrai solo con gli occhi miei, ed il mondo la sua luce riavrà. Io t'amo, 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 oh, oh, questo è il primo segno che dà la tua fede del Signor, del Signor, del Signor.
Il Signore ci dà.